It is my opinion that most of the bunkai or kata or pumse applications I've seen on the internet are totally stupid, and they are nothing close to what the form is showing. They're just made up in a fantasy world, and they don't make any sense, and there's nothing logical about it either. Now, I'm not saying bunkai or application to forms is a stupid thing. It's a real thing, and there are actual bunkai that are real and actually are practical and would probably work or have a higher chance of working. But I've seen so many fantastical channels on YouTube where people are doing karate and they're claiming all these fantastic looking self-defense techniques are inside the forms. It doesn't make any sense. Most of these people are changing the stances, they're changing the direction of angles, the height of the hands, and they're doing all kinds of things that take away from the form and are not based anywhere in the form anymore, and it doesn't look anything like the form. I've seen ridiculous stuff, and the worst people who do this seem to be in Taekwondo. Now, there's some really bad karate bunkai people that are really popular on the internet, and they show one of their katas, and then 900 thumbs up, and a bunch of karate nerds just, it's like a big circle jerk or something, and they're all just like, oh yeah, that's just so profound, it's so deep, oh thank you sensei, you've really showed the deepness of karate, blah 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 blah. But how the heck do you get a move like that? And then I've seen people throw like, do like a throw or a sweep that is impractical and stupid looking. I've seen the U-shaped high and low punching. I'm thinking I'm holding the camera, hold on. So, the punching, that goes like this. And I've seen people claim it's some kind of hip throw. But that's a dumb thing because the angle to that doesn't make any logical sense for throwing. If you've taken a judo class, you're not gonna see that kind of thing on a sort of a hip throw or a basic sweep. And then I've seen people do things that they claim are throws where they're not even sweeping the foot. And then I've seen the dumbest bunkai or application in an ITF guy doing the chunji form where he thinks he's dragging someone's arm around and then throwing them. Ridiculous. If you've taken a Brazilian jiu-jitsu class, you know how an arm drag works, and that would not be the way to do it. I mean, I could show you the example, but I'm kind of doing a selfie video here, so it's hard to put it down. I mean, I could try to make a video later about it, but I'm getting really sick of this because it's embarrassing to me for traditional martial arts. Not just karate, but especially Taekwondo, the worst offenders. You've got to stop doing this. You've got to stop thinking that fighting ability purely comes from doing forms or there's secret hidden techniques that even the masters of the masters didn't know. What the Japanese or the Okinawans or the Koreans, when they created the forms, had no clue that this secret technique was in it? Well, if it's really there, that would have been passed down already and people would know. And don't tell me that, oh, they didn't pass them down. They didn't pass these techniques down to the next students. Why would you create a martial art and not pass a technique down and then leave it up to interpretation? It's the dumbest thing in the world. I'm sure some ideas may have gotten lost in translation, but I've seen decent forms applications that make sense. In my opinion, they should make sense. They should be very basic. They should stay within the directions, the proper stances, and angles of blocking and punching or attacking or kicks or striking. It shouldn't be angled off too much. People act like a form movement, like two steps in a row, are somehow part of a move that would defeat someone in defeat an attacker. But in reality, maybe it's just an exercise. It's showing both sides of your body moving the same muscles on each side. Have you ever thought that maybe forms are just an exercise in movement and helping you master moving your body and controlling it? It's not always a secret lethal killing technique, although there are some that are like that. I think tiny pieces of forms can be put in different places in a self-defense situation, but so one block can be used in various ways. Of course, a block is also a strike in some instances, but I think a lot of people know what I'm talking about, especially if you've sparred MMA in the gym or kickboxing or jiu-jitsu, and you don't limit yourself to one thing, you're gonna understand that these kinds of concepts wouldn't work in a fight. The Bunkai doesn't work. It's a movie fight scene, or it just doesn't make sense. Why would you hold your hand up in the air like that? Because the form has their hand holding it up in the air. And then they think they're punching a guy and throwing him, or they're grabbing a shirt and throwing a guy over their shoulder, and then their hand is in the air really high. It doesn't make sense why their hand would be placed in that area. And then sometimes I've seen people who, if they try to do the technique in the form that looks like the form, they're putting themselves in danger to like an arm triangle choke or something. So people stop this, and then stop worshiping these YouTube gods. It's ridiculous. These YouTube karate and taekwondo people. Yeah, I guess that's me. I'm a YouTube taekwondo guy, whatever. But what I mean is, we should be able to criticize them, and they shouldn't get their panties in a bunch because people detract from what they agree with. Especially that guy who claims that pulling the arm back in traditional punching doesn't generate power. That's ridiculous. It definitely generates power. And he thinks it's either pulling only or it can generate power, and it can't be both. Well, that's an idiotic position. Of course it's both. You can pull someone's shirt, you can pull their arm in a joint lock, and you can also not pull them, and pulling your arm back still generates power. It helps your body rotate. It generates, helps you rotate your hips. It's putting your full body into a punch. If you don't do that, you're only punching with one arm. Only half of your body will move. Your hips will move better if you rotate both parts of your both limbs. Even boxers do it from this position. They may not have their hand here pulling, but they do this. And when they punch, they pull back, and then the other hand punches, like a jab jab cross combo. It's the same principle, Newton's third law of motion, the opposite reaction principle. People come up with the dumbest reasons for having your hands down by your hip. Obviously, when you're in a self-defense situation, you're not always going to walk around with your hands up. So maybe that's just a neutral position where you're punching from a lower position, and then from boxing or kickboxing, you're punching from a higher position. You should know how to punch from lower and higher positions, not just one. So please stop creating dumb Bunkai videos, and stop, Taekwondo people, stop trying to copy that and act like that's profound and super deep. I'm not against Bunkai, and I'm not against forms applications, and I think Taekwondo really needs to do that. But we've got to make it realistic, and we've got to understand that some of these moves are a little more simple than you're making them. I'm just frustrated by seeing this stuff. So that's just my opinion. If you don't like it, okay, big deal. Get over it. Continue being a karate nerd. Continue being a professor of Bunkai and not actually sparring people and proving it. And don't never ever use anyone who resists you, because obviously, if they don't resist you, it's not going to work. And you can't show the audience that and have all of your people sucking up to you in the audience and going, oh, and clapping and clapping and clapping. Oh, he's so profound. It was so spiritual. I mean, this is ridiculous. And this is why people have disrespected traditional martial arts to begin with, because you don't keep it in reality and you just keep doing stupid things for the views, man, for the views and the ad revenue. There's just too much of this crap. I don't know what to say. I'm out.